let's talk about purpose and destiny very quickly. Proverbs 19:21 is my favorite verse of scripture, and it says, many are the plans in a man's heart, but it is what? The Lord's purpose that will prevail. I like Psalm 57 verse 2. It says, I cry out to God Most High, the God who will fulfill his purpose for me. He sends from heaven and saves me, rebuking those who hotly pursue me. I love this verse. God gave you birth, gave you a purpose for your birth, and then he commits himself to fulfill it for you. Then he says, if anyone try to stop you, he'll get them. You better clap hands for that verse. That's a powerful verse. Whatever you were born to do, God is going to protect you through developing it. And he will come from heaven to save you. In other words, heaven is on the side of God's purpose for your life. Now let's talk about how strong purpose is. Very important. Psalm 138 verse 8 says, the Lord will fulfill his purpose for me. Then it says, your love, O Lord, endures forever. Do not abandon the works of your hands. In other words, God will never abandon what he gave you birth to do. That is what I want to get to here. He will not abandon you, but the question is, will you abandon it? Will you abandon the purpose that God gave you birth to do? This is what the Holy Spirit spoke to me about tonight. He wants to make sure that you do not miss what he's already guaranteed for you to succeed in. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 11, I love it. It says, in him we were also chosen, having been predestined, according to the plan of him who works out everything to conform to the purpose of his will. That's a powerful verse. A couple points here in this verse. Number one, he says, you were chosen. God handpicked you before you was conceived to fulfill something for him. Secondly, it says, you were predestined. In other words, he set your destination before he began you. He set your end before he started you. So you came into earth because there's something God already ended. You're supposed to begin. Your life is not an experiment. You are not a mistake. You are not a biological accident. There's something God already destined for you that made you come into this world. And then it says, he will conform everything to his will. This is very important, because when I read it some years ago, I forgot to study this verse with the word all. He works out everything, all things, to conform to his purpose for your life. He didn't say he worked out all the good things or the right things. He works out what? Everything. That means if you make a mistake, God will use the mistake and turn it into a testimony and keep your purpose going. That means if you fail in something, whether it's a marriage or pregnancy or commitment to school, or if you lost some kind of business you had, God still takes all of that and he conforms it. He brings it into the program to keep you on course. In other words, your mistakes are not more powerful than your purpose. No failure can stop God's destiny for your life. Only you can stop it. Now, I love what God says. God is still committed to your destiny, but my question is, are you? And I'm asking this question because we're going to answer this in a few minutes, and you got to answer it yourself, actually.